Hi, my name is Dr. Leila Landowski, and today I'm going to be taking you through the five components of a polysynaptic reflex arc. So I'm going to use the flexion or withdrawal reflex arc as an example, and also I'll talk quickly about the crossed extension reflex as well. So a polysynaptic reflex has five components, and the only thing that's simpler than a polysynaptic reflex is a monosynaptic reflex. And that only has four components. So we call it a monosynaptic reflex because the word mono means one. So it's got one synapse between the sensory neuron and the motor neuron. So poly means many, and what that means therefore is that a polysynaptic reflex has many synapses between the sensory neuron and the motor neuron. And usually between the sensory and the motor neuron would be an interneuron or many interneurons. Okay, so we know that a reflex is, you know, this rapid, involuntary, totally pre-programmed response that either activates muscles or glands, and it does that to help us avoid potential tissue damage or from making more tissue damage if we've already damaged it somehow. Right, so this means that it needs to be extremely fast, and because it needs to be really fast, it actually circumvents the brain, goes straight through the spinal cord, back through to the affected tissue, in this case a muscle, which allows you to avoid whatever that damaging stimulus was and prevents you from getting further damage. So, as I mentioned, the polysynaptic reflex is made of five components, and let's walk through those different components together. Okay, so any simple reflex has a sensory or an afferent component and a motor or efferent component, okay? So let's start with the sensory part, where it all begins. So let's say, I've stepped on something sharp here. That hurts, and that sharp thing that's digging into your foot is actually going to be the stimulus. Okay, so we have to turn that stimulus, that mechanical energy, into electrical energy. So there are actually nociceptors here in the skin which are going to be stimulated by this injury, okay? So those nociceptors are the first part of the reflex. So receptors are the first part of the reflex. So activation of those nociceptors will make those sensory neurons depolarize and send an action potential all the way up the leg to the spinal cord, okay? So the first component is the receptor, and in this case, that's a nociceptor. And the second component is the sensory neuron, or the afferent neuron, okay? So what the afferent sensory neuron does, like I said, it uses electrical energy in the form of an action potential, and it sends that signal all the way up the leg to the central nervous system, or in this case, this part of the spinal cord. And then the next stage is the third component of the reflex arc, and that is what we call the integration center. So in this scenario, the integration center is going to be a neuron or neurons in the spinal cord, okay? And what these interneurons do is it takes this signal from the sensory neuron and it sends it off to wherever else it needs to go. So in this case, we know it needs to go to a lower motor neuron, and this lower motor neuron, or again, an efferent neuron, is the fourth component of that reflex arc, okay? So how do you know the difference, or how do you remember the difference between afferent signals and efferent signals? Just to remind you, an efferent signal goes to the effector. Efferent goes to the effector, okay? So E and E. So in this case, the effector is actually the muscle of your leg, as you can see here. And it's going to make you lift up your leg, flex your leg. It's going to cause flexion, as the withdrawal reflex name implies, making you lift up your leg and get away from that sharp object. Now, I don't want to make this too confusing, but it's really important to point out that, you know, there's actually a second reflex that is happening at the same time, and it's called the crossed extension reflex. So it basically exists to trigger extension in the opposite limb to help preserve your balance so you don't topple over. You know, if you're only lifting up one leg or moving one leg, it's going to cause an imbalance. So you need to counter that, and in order to stop you from falling over. So you'll notice that it's going to trigger flexion in the leg that it's receiving the stimulus in, and then it actually causes extension in the opposite limb. So the integration center here, in this case, these interneurons, are sending signals to both sets of motor neurons, causing either flexion or extension. Okay, so let's do a quick recap of these five different parts of the simple reflex arc. So the first part is the receptor that detects the stimulus, turns it into electrical energy. In this case, they were nociceptors, and those nociceptors trigger the sensory neuron, which is part two, the sensory neuron, to send a signal all the way through to the spinal cord. And in the spinal cord, we find the integration center, this collection of interneurons, which then decides what to do. It's like, what do I do with this information? Okay, it says, okay, well, I want to send information to part four, the lower motor neuron, the efferent pathway, and that comes out of the spinal cord and it goes all the way down to the effector. In this case, is going to be that muscle in the leg, causing it to contract. Okay, so the effector is the fifth part. So this is an overview of a simple polysynaptic reflex.